Thanks for tuning in. If you're watching on YouTube, be sure to hit the subscribe button to stay up to date on all our latest video content. If you're watching on LocalGov TV, be sure to visit their website to see all of the content made for you by your local governments. Alamance County is pleased to present the Alamance County Commissioners Meeting.
Please come to order. This is the December 3rd, 2018, 9 a.m. meeting of Alamance County Board of Commissioners. You might want to note the time and your time you parked, because the City of Graham is giving parking tickets, and so I don't want you to get an unfriendly notice when you leave the meeting this morning. All five commissioners are present, so Vice Chair Lashley, if you would please lead us in the invocation and the pledge.
Let us pray. Gracious Heavenly Father, we pause at this time to honor you. We honor you in the way we live our lives, the way we treat other people, and we just ask for this special time of the season to honor you in every way we can. We ask you to continue to bless our nation, bless this day and this food. In your holy name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
The food of brains.
We'll never get
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
All right, if everyone has had the opportunity to review the agenda, if we could have a motion to approve it.
So moved.
Second.
Thank you, gentlemen. We have a motion and a second. All in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Anyone opposed? And then we also have a consent agenda, several items on it. If everyone has had the opportunity to review the consent agenda, if there's nothing that needs to be attended to, you have a motion.
Move approval.
Thank you.
Second.
Thank you. We have a motion and a second to approve the consent agenda. Is there any further discussion? If not, all in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Anyone opposed? Thank you. All right, Mr. Bird, today is your last meeting with us.
It is.
And do you have any remarks to make?
Yes.
The floor is yours.
Indulge me for about 10 or 12 minutes. I'd appreciate it. First of all, I would like to congratulate both you, Amy, and Steve for your wins a month ago in the general election. I appreciate that you both ran clean campaigns, and your wins were solid, and I accept that, and I wish you the very best. I've heard others say, when stepping down from public office, what an honor and privilege it is to serve as an elected official, and I'm here to tell you it's true. Serving in public office is an awesome experience. It's been arguably one of the highlights of my life, and I'm grateful for having that opportunity to serve, an opportunity that relatively few people ever get to have. I would like to offer some reflections from the last 4 years, both some things that I've had the privilege of learning, for which I had no idea, and you're going to hear that phrase often, as well as some things of which I'm most proud. First, I've learned that Alamance County has tremendous staff. I had no idea. It's been such a joy to work with them, and I've learned a lot from them, especially with whom I've worked most closely, Susan, Stacy, Tim Britton, now Cliff, Kirk, MJ, Brian and Tori, Susan, Craig, Clyde, Gary and Linda, and the list goes on, and I couldn't name them all. The important work of government is carried out not by us on this dais, but by our staff, and we have some of the best. We have amazing programs and services in Alamance County. We must make sure that our staff throughout the ranks are supported and that they remain engaged, or we'll lose them, and that will cost us taxpayers more in the end. An engaged and satisfied staff will ensure that services are delivered effectively and efficiently. That means making sure that our compensation packages are market competitive and that we're employing the best management practices in managing and supporting our staff. I'm proud of my steadfast support of public education through my words, deeds, and votes on this board. This was the main reason I ran for office over 4 years ago. For me, there is nothing more important to our community than to make sure that our kids, and I mean all of our kids, receive the very best education possible so that they can succeed in life. This means being taught by the best teachers, using the best methods with good supports in excellent facilities. Investing in education provides the strong foundation that enables our community to thrive and prosper later on. I've learned a lot by being a liaison to the Board of Education. I had no idea. I'm so glad that the school bonds passed, and I hope this board executes them as the voters pass them. I've been proud to be the commissioner appointee to the Alamance Achieve Steering Committee. There is a lot of work to be done outside of our schools to impact the success of our kids inside of our schools and beyond. Alamance Achieves is a community-wide initiative that exists to organize and align community resources to help ensure that all children thrive and succeed in their education from cradle to career. It takes a village to educate our kids. It's way more than just the schools. Think of Alamance Achieves as the village organizer. It is so important for our future, and I hope that my replacement from this board to the Alamance Achieves Steering Committee enjoys this work and sees the importance of it as much as I have. I learned a lot about public libraries and how important they are in the continuum of public education resources, not only complementing our public and private educational systems, but also expanding and helping to ensure literacy throughout our community and among all age groups. I had no idea. For many, it's the only resource they have to help improve themselves. I was proud to serve on the Public Library's Advisory Committee and its Strategic Planning Committee. I'm proud of the leadership role I brought to this board, utilizing my background in strategic planning at Alamance Regional Medical Center for our county's strategic planning initiative, resulting in our adopting the five strategic pillars: world-class education, preserving agriculture, smart growth and development, public health and safety, and government accountability and resource management, and incorporating those pillars into our strategic plan, Vision Alamance. This was the first strategic planning initiative since 2003, back when David Cheek was county manager. I hope the board continues to execute the strategies of the Vision Alamance and uses that plan to guide future budget decisions. Because of my role as commissioner, and more specifically as the commissioner representative on the Board of Health, I learned about racial equity. I had no idea. It started when our first Elon Alamance health partner at the health department, Shelby Smith, a few years ago twisted my arm to attend a two-day program of the Racial Equity Institute that she arranged to come to Alamance County for the first time, using grant money she had obtained. She was working on reducing racial disparities in maternal and child health. Shelby astutely pointed out that we will never reduce or eliminate racial disparities in public health or in any of our society's systems until we address systemic racism. For me, that program was transformational in how I view and understand race and racism, especially systemic racism, and how systemic racism continues to manifest itself in our society in profound ways. This applies especially to African Americans, and it applies to other people of color as well, including our immigrant populations. Again, I had no idea. I now proudly serve as the finance coordinator of the Alamance Racial Equity Alliance, which continues to bring REI training programs to Alamance County. I would like to invite each of you, fellow commissioners, to a future REI program. The next one is scheduled for March 1st and 2nd. Commissioners in Chatham, Guilford, Durham, Wake, and Orange, and other counties across the state are doing this. Burlington Police Chief Jeff Smythe called it amazing and powerful training and uses the quote, "How will I live now that I've seen?" In fact, I believe it behooves all elected and appointed officials to do this training. We don't know what we don't know. We all have racial biases and prejudices, especially us white people, and now I know better what biases I've had and where they came from. We will all benefit when racism is eliminated. Because of this training, I'm proud to have been able to bring at least some conversation about racism to this board, possibly the first commissioner to do so in a long time. Because of my position, I've learned a lot about childhood trauma, toxic stress, and the Adverse Childhood Experiences Study, or ACEs, that's been ongoing for the past 25 years or so by the Centers for Disease Control in Atlanta and the Kaiser Permanente Foundation. This learning began when I was arm twisted, once again, this time to attend the National Conference of Family Justice Centers, Judge Overby, you were there with me, in Milwaukee a couple of years ago, filling in for the sheriff who had to cancel due to a family circumstance. This is where I was exposed to the research that showed childhood trauma, and I'm talking about things like sexual abuse, physical abuse or neglect, parents who abuse each other, having a parent who's incarcerated, etc., there's several of them, were linked to adult cancer, heart disease, mental illness, incarceration rates, lower life expectancy, and a host of other issues later in life. I had no idea. For me, it was about as transformational as my exposure to racial equity training. This is where I also was exposed to the issues of domestic violence and the relationship between childhood trauma and domestic violence victims. I would invite each of you to attend a screening of the documentary entitled Resilience, The Biology of Stress and the Science of Hope, which clearly explains this research produced by James Redford, Robert Redford's son. A copy of this documentary is available at May Library, and a series of screenings is being coordinated by Sally Gordon, the current Elon Alamance health partner at the Health Department. The result of this science-based research is being touted as the most important medical breakthrough in a generation, and I feel it is important for all of us to know about it. The documentary has been shown multiple times at North Carolina Association of County Commissioner meetings and is being shown across the state and the country. I promise it will give you a whole new perspective about our most serious health and social challenges and their root causes. As the commissioner appointee, I've been extremely proud to have chaired the Justice Advisory Council, which oversees the Family Justice Center and the Stepping Up Initiative. I had no idea of the prevalence of domestic violence and the incarceration of the mentally ill in Alamance County. I've been especially proud of my role in establishing the Stepping Up Initiative, which, as you know, exists to reduce the number of people with mental illness in our jail, the worst place for them to be, and costly to taxpayers. Working with this initiative, I've learned a lot about mental illness and co-occurring substance use disorders, and I've gained a new and deep appreciation of our law enforcement officers throughout the community, how they really do care about people and are there to help. Both the Family Justice Center and the Stepping Up Initiative are important to this community, not only to the domestic violence victims themselves and those with mental illness, but to their families and to the entire community. Whichever one of you takes my place on that, I ask that you help ensure that these programs continue to thrive. After retiring from Alamance Regional Medical Center and taking the oath of office, never would I have expected to be so involved in health issues again. I had no idea. I've learned so much about public health, serving on the Board of Health, as I mentioned, and on the Board of Health's Environmental Health Committee. Equally informative has been serving on the North Carolina Local Health Department Accreditation Board and its Standards and Evidence Committee. This was a Secretary of Health and Human Services appointment after being nominated by the Commissioners Association. I've also learned a lot about mental health, intellectual and developmental disabilities, and substance use disorders by serving on the Cardinal Innovations Healthcare Board of Directors. The bulk of this board was appointed by commissioner representatives from the 20 county catchment area of Cardinal, and I was proud to serve on that appointing body representing this board here. I'm pleased that I will be able to continue to serve on the Cardinal board, as the seat I occupy is one designated for a person who has expertise in healthcare administration and not one designated for a county commissioner. I've learned a lot about public transportation by serving on the Piedmont Authority for Transport for Regional Transportation Board, PART, the Alamance County Transportation Authority Board, ACTA, and the Link Transit Public Advisory Commission as the commissioner representative on each. I had no idea how important public transportation is for those who cannot drive or own a vehicle for a variety of reasons to get to school, work, or medical appointments. I've learned how important it is for others to have that option, to get out of their personal vehicles to help eliminate road congestion, eliminate the need for more concrete highway lanes, mitigate air pollution, and avoid parking issues, all of which benefit everyone while being able to enjoy the convenience of not driving to get to their destinations. I am proud to have cast one of the three votes, along with Eddie and Amy, that ensured that Part would not only continue service to Alamance County, but to expand service here. And I'm proud of my role that ensured that these three transportation services continue to exist to provide local, urban, rural, and inner-city transportation options in a coordinated fashion. Lastly, and I suppose most importantly, I've learned a lot by serving on the board of the North Carolina Association of County Commissioners and participating in its many programs. It's amazing to learn how other counties face some of the same issues that we face. I will cherish the many friendships I've established with commissioners across the state and across the political spectrum. I'm very proud to have served on the board and as chair of the Health and Human Services Steering Committee. It was through the North Carolina Association, along with the National Association of Counties, that we established the Stepping Up Initiative here. And it was through the State Association that we held two very successful opioid epidemic leaders summits here in Alamance County, on whose planning committee I served. The opioid work continues under the leadership of Ray Vipperman, director of the county's EMS service, and many others in county government and in the private sector. In summary, I've learned a lot, and I'm proud of what I've done as a commissioner. My life has been greatly enriched, and I hope that I've made a positive impact on our community, knowing that any real power any commissioner has exists only through the one vote out of five that each has to cast. I've tried to stay true to my values as I've approached and taken positions on some controversial issues, mouth is getting dry, as those around 287G, the Confederate Monument, countywide zoning, the proposed pipeline, and proposed tax increases in order to invest in our community for the benefit of all. I've tried to be open-minded, honest, transparent, collaborative, inclusive, and financially responsible. I would hope that the board, with its new single-party makeup, will try to consider the voices of all Alamance County residents with open minds when deliberating on future decisions, including the voices of the over 25,000 voters who voted for me. I would like to say that I've enjoyed working with this board on the dais today, Tim, Eddie, Amy, and Bill, and with the other members with whom I've served during my first 2 years, Dan Engel, the late Linda Massey, David Smith, and Roger Parker. We all agreed on issues way more than we disagreed. Serving in public office can be challenging as we serve in a fishbowl. I would like to thank my wife, Barbara, for her steadfast support of me in this role. Barbara, raise your hand, everybody can see it. For her steadfast support of me in this role and for being my closest counselor, advisor, and friend, for helping me work through what was the right thing to do and what was not during those times when it wasn't immediately clear. With that, I would just like to say thank you to Alamance County for giving me this amazing opportunity to serve you over the last 4 years. I will be forever changed and I will be eternally grateful. Thank you. Thank you.
All right, thank you for that, Bob. I'm going to come around. We'll have a presentation in front. I just very briefly, we don't usually recognize elected officials when they come to visit. We'll make an exception this time. We have State Senator Rick Gunn and House Representative Steve Ross from House District 63 here today. So we're very happy to have you.
What are you doing over it, Tim?
I asked a question. I wouldn't have done that if I knew that was going to happen.
Okay. I have a plaque to present to you, Bob. I want to say, of course, I think we all know that last week, President George H.W. Bush passed away at the end of a very servant-oriented and productive and memorable and life. And in the course of reading things about his life, I found this quote: "You can be political opponents and still work together for something more important than your own political future. I thought that was very appropriate for today, and I have a plaque to present to you, Bob. It says, in recognition of outstanding service and leadership, presented to Robert Bob Byrd, December 2014-2018, Alamance County Board of Commissioners, December 3rd, 2018. And then it lists the committees that he has served on: Alamance County Transportation Authority, Board of Education Liaison, Board of Health, Cardinal Innovations Healthcare, Central Community Board, Piedmont Authority for Regional Transportation, Justice Advisory Council, Library Committee, North Carolina Association of County Commissioners Board of Directors, Public Transit Advisory Commission, and Stepping Up Mental Health Steering Committee. We missed any.
Ran out of room.
I know.
Next on our agenda is to administer the oath of office for, looks like I go first, for me, so I should have just stayed down there. So I guess I'll come down and have the honor of being sworn in by the honorable and incomparable, unsuppressible, Larry Brown. I'll give some credit to you, I don't know what I'm going to say. And I have my mom and my dad and my son Sam here. This is my son Sam. He's 16. He's a sophomore at Williams. His brother and sister are at college. And this is my mom, Carla Scott. And this is my dad, Dr. Sam Scott.
If you place your left hand on the Bible, raise your right, and repeat after me. I, Amy Scott Gailey.
I, Amy Scott Gailey.
Do solemnly swear.
Do solemnly swear.
That I will support and maintain.
That I will support and maintain.
The Constitution and laws of the United States.
The Constitution and laws of the United States.
And the Constitution and laws of North Carolina.
And the Constitution and laws of North Carolina.
Not inconsistent therewith.
Not inconsistent therewith.
And that I will faithfully discharge.
And that I will faithfully discharge.
The duties of my office.
The duties of my office.
As County Commissioner for the County of Alamance.
As County Commissioner for the County of Alamance.
So help me God.
So help me God.
I, Amy Scott Gailey.
I, Amy Scott Gailey.
Do swear that I will.
Do swear that I will.
Well and truly execute.
Well and truly execute.
The duties of the office.
The duties of the office.
Of County Commissioner for the County of Alamance.
Of County Commissioner for the County of Alamance.
According to the best of my skill.
According to the best of my skill.
And ability.
And ability.
According to law.
According to law.
So help me God.
So help me God.
Congratulations.
Stephen Carter, going to be sworn in by Judge Overby.
My Bible is on my phone, so can I borrow yours?
Of course. We have to write some in there. This Bible was huge.
That works.
Steve, the line is never busy. Always open.
That's right.
Place your left hand on the Bible, raise your right hand, and repeat after me.
I, Stephen J. Carter.
I, Stephen J. Carter.
Do solemnly swear.
Do solemnly swear.
That I will support and maintain.
That I will support and maintain.
The Constitution and laws of the United States.
The Constitution and laws of the United States.
And the Constitution and laws.
And the Constitution and laws.
Of North Carolina.
Of North Carolina.
Not inconsistent therewith.
Not inconsistent therewith.
And I will faithfully discharge.
And I will faithfully discharge.
The duties of my office.
The duties of my office.
As County Commissioner.
As County Commissioner.
For the County of Alamance.
For the County of Alamance.
So help me God.
So help me God.
I, Stephen J. Carter.
I, Stephen J. Carter.
Do swear.
Do swear.
That I will well and truly execute.
That I will well and truly execute.
The duties of the office.
The duties of the office.
Of County Commissioner.
Of County Commissioner.
For the County of Alamance.
For the County of Alamance.
According to the best of my skill and ability.
According to the best of my skill and ability.
According to law.
According to law.
So help me God.
So help me God. Thank you.
Steve?
Yeah, hey. Steve's coming up. Somebody help.
Too much.
Congratulations, Steve. We're glad you're here.
Can I pass them a copy of the agenda?
The agenda up to date.
All right. Next on our agenda is to take care of our board organization and to select a chair. Mr. Haygood?
At this time, commissioners, the board will be asked to nominate and elect a chair. So at this time, I would like to ask, is there a nomination for the chair of the Alamance County Board of Commissioners?
I nominate Amy Gailey, chairman.
We have a nomination. Is there a second?
Second.
We have a second. All in favor of Amy Gailey as chair of the Alamance County Board of Commissioners, please signify by saying aye.
Aye. Aye.
Congratulations, Chair Amy.
Thank you. Gentlemen, for your confidence. I really appreciate that.
Good job.
I've been trying to do a good job, and I promise I'll keep trying to do one. Next on our agenda is to select a vice chair. Do we have any nominations?
I nominate Eddie Boswell.
Second.
Okay, we have a motion and a second for Eddie Boswell to be vice chair. Are there any further nominations? If not, the nominations will be closed. Do we have any discussion? If not, all in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Anyone opposed? Great. Thank you. Mr. Boswell. Okay. Next we have Mr. David Morrow to be sworn in by Larry Brown.
Congratulations.
Of course. Y'all all have to sign my Bible. I want a record that it was used.
That's right.
Bible's getting a workout.
That's right.
Would you place your left hand on the Bible? Will you affirm? I, David Lee Morrow.
I, David Lee Morrow.
Do solemnly affirm.
Do solemnly affirm.
That I will support and maintain.
That I will support and maintain.
The Constitution and laws.
The Constitution and laws.
Of the United States.
Of the United States.
And the Constitution and laws.
And the Constitution and laws.
Of North Carolina.
Of North Carolina.
Not inconsistent therewith.
Not inconsistent therewith.
And that I will faithfully discharge.
And that I will faithfully discharge.
The duties of my office.
The duties of my office.
As Alamance County Soil and Water Conservation.
As Alamance County Soil and Water Conservation.
District Supervisor.
District Supervisor.
So help me God.
So help me God.
I, David Lee Morrow.
I, David Lee Morrow.
Do solemnly and sincerely.
Do solemnly and sincerely.
Affirm that I will support.
Affirm that I will support
the Constitution of the United States.
The Constitution of the United States.
That I will be faithful.
That I will be faithful.
And bear true allegiance.
And bear true allegiance.
To the state of North Carolina.
To the state of North Carolina.
And to the constitutional powers.
And to the constitutional powers.
And authorities which are.
And the authorities which are.
Or may be established.
Or may be established.
For the government thereof.
For the government thereof.
And that I will endeavor to support.
And that I will endeavor to support.
Maintain and defend.
Maintain and defend.
The Constitution of said state.
The Constitution of said state.
Not inconsistent with.
Not inconsistent with.
The Constitution of the United States.
The Constitution of the United States.
To the best of my knowledge.
To the best of my knowledge.
And ability.
And ability.
So help me God.
So help me God.
I, David Lee Morrow.
I, David Lee Morrow.
Do affirm.
Do affirm.
That I will well and truly.
That I will well and truly.
Execute the duties.
Execute the duties.
Of the office of.
Of the office of.
Alamance County Soil and Water Conservation.
Alamance County Soil and Water Conservation.
District Supervisor.
District Supervisor.
According to the best of my skill.
According to the best of my skill.
And ability.
And ability.
According to law.
According to law.
So help me God.
So help me God.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Lovely. Thank you so much, Judge. Okay, next on our agenda is a request to set a public hearing. Mac Williams from the Chamber of Commerce.
Good morning, Commissioners. Congratulations, Steve. Congratulations, Amy. Congratulations, Mr. Morrow. My name is Mac Williams. I'm president of the Alamance Chamber. And I've got a pleasure today to ask you folks on the board to set a date for December 17th for a public hearing to consider incentives for a new manufacturer that's looking at Alamance County. The name of that company is Becton Dickinson. They have a facility in Mebane, and this project would look to substantially grow that facility. More details will be forthcoming. In fact, the city of Mebane's public hearing on this very same project is this evening at 6. So I would ask that you set the date for the 17th for the county here.
So moved.
Second.
Thank you, gentlemen. We have a motion and a second to set a public hearing for economic incentives for Becton Dickinson on December 17th, 2018. Is there any discussion?
Have we given that company incentives in the past?
You know, that's a good question. Locally, I am not aware that we have, but I can check that and be prepared to answer that question.
And a long time ago.
I'll be prepared to answer that question on the 17th.
There's no further discussion. All in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Anyone opposed? Thank you. All right, we have a resolution certifying the referendum results.
Good morning, Commissioners. You have in your packet and before you a resolution certifying the referendum results of the November 6, 2018 vote. You also have in your packet a copy of the Certificate of Canvass from the Alamance County Board of Elections indicating the results of the Alamance Permanent School System and ACC bond vote. So this resolution that's before you today that we're asking you to consider and approve, it serves as official notice to both the public and the local government commission that the ABSS and ACC bond votes did in fact pass. This resolution has been prepared by the county's bond attorney. It's been reviewed by the county attorney and by our finance officer also and found to be in good standing. The resolution will be included in information that we send to the local government commission once we start applying to issue debt. So at this time, I'd be happy to answer any questions, but what you're being asked to do this morning is to approve this resolution, indicating that the vote was held. The results are that both bonds passed according to the numbers in the resolution. So
we can do both of them in one vote?
Yes, it's one resolution with both in. So.
So moved. I'll move that we approve it.
Second.
Unless somebody else did. That's your
good. So we have a motion and a second to approve the referendum certifying the result or approving a resolution certifying the referendum results. Is there any further discussion?
I think it's just of note of the percentage of voters for each one, that people are very in favor doing this for education. And I think we need to keep that in mind as we move forward.
Okay. Any other discussion? If not, all in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Anyone opposed? Thank you. Okay, Ms. Evans?
Madam Chair, I have two quick slides to show you just to update the board on the calendar for the upcoming bond information. So just very quickly, you've just approved the resolution certifying the results. I wanted to went over some of this information last time we were up at the historic courthouse. Today, we've been working with the school system and with the community college staff to confirm their project timelines, their project costs, and what possible upfront funding they may need for design work. We have asked them to have us that information confirmed today. We'll also be working this week. We went down last week, met with the local government commission to talk about the possibility of structuring the debt. You remember we talked about this was a way to push some of the higher principal payments out. It does cost more interest. They have some concerns. We did meet with the local government commission. They are debating our ability to use this. We hope to know this week if they're going to allow the county to at least consider this structured option. We also have to remind
Mr.
the board.
Could I interrupt you just a second and pause on that? Because I went on the trip to Raleigh as well, and I wanted to just take a moment to ask if there's any, but pretty much what Mr. Haygood has said is what happened. We went there and made a pitch as to why Alamance County should have the authority to decide whether or not we do structured or level principal, and demonstrated that we're well aware of the trade-offs involved. But I wanted to see if there's any questions that you all had or comments or concerns before we move forward from that, because that's a pretty important step, and I want to be sure that y'all are fully informed and
so what was their drawback of not doing it? Sounds to me like there was some negatives in there for stretching this out.
So the local government commission favors level principal. They prefer that method. They have some concerns. They say it will require that we pay more interest. What using structured debt will allow us to keep the property tax impact lower on the front end, but it will mean we'll pay more interest over time. There's some concern that it could mean that we might have issues borrowing money again in the future, which we told the LGC we don't do a lot of borrowing. We have about $53 million worth of debt right now, so we're not a county known for carrying large amounts of debt. But that is a legitimate concern if we wanted to borrow large amounts of money in the future. I think those were two of the main issues that they had. And the structured debt option exists under the statute. We're legally allowed to do this. And we'll be bringing on the 17th some changed policies that will help us stay in compliance with the statute too. So we made those points, I think, to the local government commission that the county commissioners should have the ability to at least consider this, debate it, and make a decision locally about what to do. So I think that was pretty well summed up. Yes.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I think that there is definitely a bias against, or a bias in favor of having debt capacity in your budget. And they seem to favor the idea that as debt rolls off, that you will take on new debt to continue to build. And, you know, sort of Alamance County's approach has been that when that debt rolls off, you know, reduce the tax rate or give the taxpayer some kind of relief. And I think the people at the local government commission seem to believe that while the state is growing, that counties need to be able to take out more debt. So that was kind of a source of discussion right there.
LGC is an excellent resource for us. We use them. They help us ensure that when we do borrow money, that we do it in the right way. And they've been instrumental in keeping North Carolina's credit overall great. We're one of the best credit rated states in the nation. So this process is good. It means local governments can't just do anything they want. They need to go talk to the professionals and get their input. But we believe that the county should have the ability to consider this and determine what's more important, paying some additional interest or being able to lower the property tax impact. So,
I
mean, they don't have to approve it. I mean, it's just a formality. Yeah.
Statutorily, we can do it.
Yeah.
They will be the group that issues our debt,
right,
also. So we want to work in tandem with them,
right,
and have them.
And I would also say that they're more concerned with the appearance or the analysis of the government entity than they are the taxpayers who pay the freight. And so I've seen times where I don't agree with a thing the local government commission says and/or their interpretation of a statute. I've differed many times with them, but I think that's our choice to call.
Well, I think that was you know, I myself and some of our staff had traveled to see the LGC back in March of this year, and we had this discussion. And I think it was helpful to have the chair of the board go, because that brings the elected officials' perspective on this question. Because you have staff talking to staff, that's of course important, and that's one thing. But you need that perspective of you know, you speak for the people. So
sure.
I thought that was very helpful.
I think that pending the outcome of our discussions with the LGC, I'm hopeful that they will decide that in our favor and agree that this should be a decision made by the elected officials of Alamance County and not people in Raleigh. I hope that they will agree with that. However, if they do not agree, I think it would be useful to have an understanding from the county attorney and from the bond attorney what our options are, so that we know, can respond appropriately.
And we have some time for that. It would be dependent. We'll bring you some timetables that will show when we'll issue debt. So we have a little bit of time, but we would prefer to get this straightened out with the LGC on the front end. So.
Thank you.
We do have a meeting scheduled back at the LGC in Raleigh on December 7th. Myself and several staff members will be going down with staff from the school system and the community college just to meet with the LGC to talk about the logistics of what they're going to require before they'll allow the county to issue debt. It'll be a good opportunity for all of us to get on the same page. And then at the December 17th meeting, our last meeting, I indicated that I would be bringing you revised fiscal policies today. We were not able to do that. We're going to have that for you on December 17th. We hope that these revised fiscal policies will help us with our credit rating when we start trying to issue this debt. And several of these new policies that will be implemented will help us be sure we stay compliant if we do use a structured option. Last two meeting dates of importance that I'm aware of at this time. On January 22nd, I'll be bringing to you a revised capital plan. Remember, I brought you a capital plan last time. Maximum estimated property tax rate impact, 7.88 cents. We're working with the school system now and ACC to see mainly how their project timings will go. That'll have a bearing on what the property tax impact might be. So I'll have that information for you at the January 22nd meeting. And then you'll be able to see it. You'll see all the projects. You'll see the timelines of the projects, right now, based on all the projects that the schools and the community college have put together, when they will be debt would be issued, we believe, when design would be done, those kind of things. And we would be able to have a much better idea of what we think the property tax impact will be. That is based on all projects at estimated cost with a new timeline. And then in February of 2019, we believe you will see a reimbursement resolution. Our discussions with the school system and the community college have indicated that they're going to have some funding up front to do design work. We're not able to issue debt to do design work alone. So they're going to need some funding. We're going to be looking at what the county has available and what each entity has available too. If we do that, we would bring a resolution to the board in February saying that once we issue the debt, if let's say we use some of our fund balance to pay for the design costs, once the debt's issued, we would reimburse our fund balance. So that's all I had to pass. I just want to keep the board up to date on what's going on, and I appreciate your time this morning. Thank you.
Now, will any contracts technically be let before we set a tax rate or say what the rate will be?
No. So what will happen is the school system will have to do design work and actually get bids before any debt can be issued. So the school system and the community college will come before the commissioners at certain times with lists of projects that have all been bid, and you'll be able to see the exact cost of each project before you agree to issue the debt. So you'll have opportunity to review projects and review their costs as we go through this process. So there's nothing in the near future with the exception of the budget. You know, as of right now, the commissioners have talked about issuing a property, implementing a property tax rate with this current budget one time to set all the revenue in place to cover all this debt. So that would be a point where when I bring you a property tax rate increase, if that continues to be the board's desire, you would have the ability to vote and set that in place. So. Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. All right, Ms. Evans.
Good morning, commissioners. Before you this morning is our request to the review of the bonds of the public officials. This is an annual certification that it would approve the bonds for Jeremy Akins, our tax administrator, Terry Johnson, our sheriff, myself as finance officer, and Hugh Webster as our register of deeds.
Make a motion to approve.
Second.
Okay, we have a motion and a second to review the bonds for those public officials. Is there any more discussion? If not, all in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Anyone opposed? Okay, we have an audit contract.
Yes, ma'am. Before you this morning is an amendment to our contract. There were several things that have impacted our audit cycle this year, weather-related, Hurricane Florence, as well as Hurricane Michael, that have delayed our filing this year. So what we are asking is for an extension with the LGC State Treasurer's Office that would give us until the end of February to file our audit. We anticipate that being filed much earlier than that, but that's just industry standard, is to go ahead and ask for a February due date. There is no increase to the cost of the audit this year. But this must be approved by our Board of Commissioners.
I'll make the motion. We approve them.
Second.
I don't think any of them's going to run off.
Okay, I believe we have a motion and a second. Is there any more discussion? If not, all in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Anyone opposed? Okay.
Thank you.
We have a lease renewal for the county landfill. Mr. Hill.
Good morning, Commissioners.
Good morning.
Welcome, Commissioner Carter. So in front of you is a request to renew a lease that we've had now for about 8 years with Ms. Barber in West Burlington area for some property that we use for one of our off-site recycle centers. I've spoken to Ms. Barber. She's in agreement with these terms. She did request a $25 a month increase, so that's included in the pricing. The site has become quite popular. We have to service it multiple times a year to bring those target recyclables down to the landfill for separation and then to sell them on the open market. So just requesting a continuation. It's a 3-year agreement with an option for another 3 years. Any questions?
I want to make one comment.
Sure.
How about going over there and labeling those cans a little better?
Sure.
I use the thing, and that's part of the reason. I know when we were doing the contracts with a lot of the Waste Management Republic, a lot of people out that way used that as their recycling bin.
Yes.
That's right. I do that too.
And label them so we can tell where it goes.
I'm going to say that I appreciate Ms. Barber being willing to let us use her property through this lease.
That's a great location.
It is.
It's a great location.
Service a lot of
people. It's a real blessing to the community to be able to use that.
And that other two off-site, that's the only one that's open 24 hours a day. The one we have out by the gym, we close on the hours set by Park and Rec, so quite popular.
Yep. I'll make a motion to approve the lease.
Second.
Okay, we have a motion and a second to approve the lease. Is there any more discussion? If not, all in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Just to update, we've talked over the last year about the recycle market really being in a mess. Things are starting to improve, although China continues to be very, very restrictive. We're actually have met our budget for recycling revenue already this year. So we're moving ahead. Problems are still there, but things are looking better.
Good.
Thank you very much, Mr. Hill. All right, next on our agenda are the public speakers. We commonly have our public speakers at the beginning of the agenda, but in the past, in reviewing the previous years when we've had a new commissioner sworn in, the public speakers were at the end. So that's what we did this time to keep it consistent with the practice in the past for these types of meetings. Today we have Anthony Pierce signed up for the public comment period. So if he is here, he'd like to come forward.
Good morning, everyone. Anthony Pierce. I'm out at Hall River. They call it Hall River, but it's really, I don't know, to the right is Grand, to the left is Meadow, so somewhere else. But at any rate, that 3 minutes goes by pretty quick, so I'm going to go ahead and get started. I'm here just to offer just a public comment related to the path forward for Alamance County. First and foremost, thank you to the current board, even Commissioner Byrd, who's left, and welcome to the board now. Congratulations to both of you. Look forward to working with you this year. Now that the elections are complete, I'm not here to rehash the elections or the outcomes. The citizens have spoken. and that's that. But one thing that was pretty crystal clear, that regardless of the party affiliations, it was determined that we must invest in education for Alamance County, as evidenced in passing of the school bonds and Commissioner Boswell forestated. Also, Alamance County is changing, you know, and I'm sure we all would agree. As we transition to 2019, I would like to encourage the commissioners to take the time to reflect on the service they provide for and to the citizens of Alamance County. Alamance County has completely evolved over the years and is no longer the same place or made up of the same citizens and views on key issues as in the past. The citizens now make up a very diverse population and are becoming more and more diverse as the growth continues. In order to fully understand the key issues, I believe, we have to hear and see from the people. We all have our own personal views and respect the views of our family, our friends, for the most part. But I believe in order to truly serve all the people of Alamance County, you have to become more involved in the forums, events, and activities that are being conducted all across this great county. And then it would be completely clear that you truly understand what the majority of the citizens of Alamance County and how they feel on key issues versus the potentially skewed views that we might have based on our personal values, our neighbors, our families, friends, or even the company that we keep. I said all that just to say one thing. I appreciate the commissioners, without naming names, that have consistently spoken about the research that they've gathered outside of these four walls on these key issues to the greater population in Alamance County. And I believe the citizens of Alamance County would have an excellent path forward, and this board would have an excellent path forward in the upcoming if they adopt that consistent approach of going outside these four walls, attending events such as the racial equality forums, the education and events being held by our future leaders. I'm fully aware that it's not enough time to attend everything, but I have a saying that I live by and I share with others. You might can't make them all, just don't miss them all. So with that, I say thank you to the commissioners, and I look forward to working with you, and I wish you all well in 2019. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Also, Tony Rose has signed up for comments. Welcome. For those of you who do not know, Mr. Rose is a school board member who was also recently reelected. Congratulations to you.
Thank you. Good morning. Congratulations to you and to Steve. I appreciate it. I've been on the school board for 8 years. I've never made a public comment at a commissioner meeting before, but I felt compelled to today. I just wanted to say a few things to you and really to members of the public that, first of all, I'm very appreciative that, Amy, that you and Bob have, many members of the public may not know that you guys come to almost all of our work sessions and our school board meetings, and I think that's brought a lot of transparency and cooperation between the two boards over the last several years. And I hope you guys will continue to do that. I am also wanted to let you guys know that rarely do you guys miss a meeting, but you did miss the one that we had the day after the election. And that was when we had our external auditor present our clean audit. And I asked in that meeting.
I was there.
Oh, were you there? I'm sorry. I didn't remember that. I asked that day that that the auditor actually come and present to you guys, because I wanted them to be available to you guys so that you could ask any questions about our finances from our external auditor. So I don't know if administration has reached out for that, but that's something that I would like to see. But I just wanted to say to you guys ultimately today is that there was integrity in the ask for this bond money. We wanted this money to build a new high school, to repair our six high schools, and to do repairs and renovations on two of our elementary schools. And it's my intention as a board member to see that that happens. And I'm speaking today as a board member, but not for my board and not for the administration. But I just wanted to let you guys know, if there's any way, any time in this process, you don't feel like you're getting the information you need, please reach out to our board, to our superintendent. I really appreciate the good relationship that Brian has with our superintendent, and our staffs work very well together. And I think a lot of times the public doesn't realize that that's happening. But we want to make sure that every nickel of this money that is given for this purpose goes to this purpose. And I want to turn around in a year and 2 years and 3 years and say, yes, everybody knows we got the money and we did this with it. And there's not any questions later. So I just wanted to reach that out and say this is a partnership. and I want to make sure that we're spending the money efficiently and that we are accountable to every nickel of it. So thank you for your time.
Before you go, may I ask a question? I think I've seen it in the past in this process, but I want to see it again if I haven't seen it, or we did see it and I don't have it now, but if we do, we have a package of all the projects as far as something you can show us as far as the dollars and exactly what the projects are?
Yes.
Okay. Stuff. Yeah. Are they in a priority line? In other words, the biggest thing obviously is the high school, I would assume, and then the major repairs, so forth, and then down to the minor. Are they in a priority order like that?
Tim, I'm going to defer your question to staff just because I want to stay in my lane and I don't want to run ahead of what they're presenting for you.
All right.
So that, I know that those guys are getting together soon, and so I would not want to speak ahead of them, okay. but my expectations would be yes.
It should
our
be.
Board would like to see that as well as you
right.
would.
It should right. be, and I would like to see that as yeah. soon as possible.
We have not seen that yet, but right. but we expect to. So
okay, thank you.
Is that fair?
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you, guys.
Thank you. Do we have any other commissioner responses to the public speakers? I would just add that Andrea Rollins also attends the school board work sessions and the school board meetings at night. She is works in for the county manager. What's your title?
Budget
now?
And management director.
Budget and management director, Andrea Rollins. And so we have a.
She also works with ACC. She's at our meetings for building and grounds, which is helpful to keep abreast of. Yes.
Andrea does a lot to be the eyes and ears for the county manager where he cannot go. And I think it's important that the public knows that, in the context of Tony being here, that she attends those school board meetings as well. So was there anything else anybody wanted to say?
I hate Bob got out before we could come.
I know, I did too.
I was thinking that we were going to get to talk about it. And,
now you can talk
Well, I mean
about
that in a positive way. I want to tell you, Bob Bird was one classy fella.
Yeah.
And he was one super intelligent fella. And, he was sharp. And
he put the time in.
Yeah, yes. Bill gave him a hard time occasionally, but but I'm going to miss him. I think
job.
He was a sharp fella, and I bet he'll be back. And one more thing. Did we get that picture done to where we could show it by chance?
Scott was in the back room.
Oh, boy. Thank you so much. I want everybody to see this. Can you blow it up? All right. The Times News, they may have run some pictures, but I just didn't see them, and surely they're available. But this was when Bush was in Burlington in 1992. And the caption underneath that picture of the person that took it, the person that took these pictures was from out of town, and he didn't know everybody. And naturally, he got Bush right. He got Coble right in the white hat. He called that middle person at the microphone Locke Faircloth, but I believe that was Jimmy Giroux, the mayor of Burlington, that introduced.
Yeah, that's who that is.
Yeah, that introduced the whole crowd. But to the right, I wouldn't have done this morning had he not sat right there and down there and was Mr. Republican in this community, in my opinion, Junior T.
I thought it was Mr. Barbie.
That's right, that's Junior T.
Yeah. If I'm not mistaken, that person on the right is Junior T, and that picture shows him as being unidentified. And I just, and Scott, to be able to get that on.
That's a good job.
And I called him at 8:15. And I said, I know this is tough. If you can't do it, I understand. But I'm proud of that picture. And there's a sheriff here.
He's doing his swearing.
Right, the sheriff, I think, knows somebody that might want that picture if he hasn't already got it. You know who I'm talking about, maybe. But That's a classy shot, and that wasn't the Times News. Again, that was an individual that took several pictures, and I was there that day. Had my little John was with me, and I put him up on a barrel, like an old barrel, that set him down to where he could see everything. And I'll never forget that day. And Strom Thurmond was there, Jesse Helms, and it was quite an event. But to be able to show Junior T down on the other side of Bush, I think is pretty important. So that's why I did it. Thank you for whoever got all that going.
That's terrific. Thank you for sharing that. All right. County Manager, do you have a report?
I just wanted to inform the board that at the December 13th Planning Board meeting, I've asked our Planning Director, Tanya Cattle, to bring up the heavy industrial development ordinance with the planning board to go over the current ordinance, how it's structured, the specifics of it, the processes, how it works, and also explain to the planning board the changes that we've done internally to make sure county staff at all different levels are notified anytime a heavy industrial development permit comes in or is approved. So I wanted to make sure the board knew that, and if you had any other instructions for the planning board or anything else you wanted them to consider. At this point, it's just to go over the particulars of the existing ordinance. So,
is there a way in that process we can look at the procedures of these requests coming in, similar to what the quarry deal, you know, it went through, and not everybody on here was, or probably not many of us were informed of that, and it's kind of like we ought to know.
Absolutely, yes. Yes, that will be a topic of discussion too. So, okay. And the only other thing I have is just to say personally, congratulations to Commissioner Carter. Congratulations, Chair Gailey, and I look forward to working with both you and the board to the rest of the year. Thank you.
Thank you. I just wanted to flesh out that a little bit about the high industrial development ordinance. Did I call it the right name? Development ordinance, and make sure that there's no other instructions from the board, because this is something the county manager and I talked about in our regular meeting. I wanted to be sure that they were asked to do what we wanted them to do. So do we want them to compare our ordinance with other counties' ordinances to see if we want them to consider how we might improve it, if there's deficiencies in it? Do you want to task the planning board with doing that, or do you want to just have them review the ordinance as is?
Well, I think we need to compare and make it as good as possible. I mean, because it's obviously not as good as possible.
It's not working.
Yeah,
there's a lot of steps that need to be added.
Yeah. Yeah.
I think the county commissioners need to approve ordinances like that.
So maybe look to other counties for examples of how we might improve the ordinance.
I think that's a good idea.
To make it more responsive to the community.
Right, because the community a lot of times are not aware that this is even going on in the planning board, because it's kind of they just can rubber stamp it pretty much because of the way our ordinance is set up.
Very good. We will do that. Thank you.
Thank you. Are there any other commissioner comments?
One more thing. Classy was replaced with Classy, and welcome, Steve.
Thank you.
Look forward to dealing with you.
Same here, Steve.
Well, I'll comment if I might for a minute about the campaign and Bob. Bob ran a very clean campaign. I encountered him a number of times during the campaign. We always enjoyed time together, and I think Bob has served the community very well. And he's obviously spent a lot of time and invested a lot of personal time in it, so he creates a challenge for all of us, it looks like. So.
You said that.
That's right. I had one thing I would like to ask the board to consider. Our public comments, I alluded to it earlier in the meeting. So we, in early 2017, this board adopted rules of procedure, and through that process, we talked about how we wanted the public comment section to fall in our agenda. And there was discussion about having two comment periods, and then we ended up ultimately just having one comment period at the beginning. I would like to ask the board to consider, and not for action today, but place it as an agenda item, possibly at the beginning of January. Consider going back to that two public comment period model, where the first comment period at the beginning of the agenda would be restricted to items that are actually on the agenda. And then if people have a public comments that they want to make about things that are not related to agenda items, have them at the end. And the reason that, and I was one that advocated in 2017 for one public comment period at the beginning, the reason that I changed my mind is because we had three agenda items which had to be tabled because our meeting ran very long, because we had people who came and with public comment items which were not related to the agenda, which resulted in a lot of discussion, which is great. You know, that's part of being in America. You have the right to petition your government, and you have the right to free speech and assembly and all of that. But when it means the county business doesn't get done in an efficient and timely manner, then I think that's when we need to look at the way we do business and make sure that the business gets done.
I think that's a good idea.
So we'll ask the manager to put that on for a meeting in the future. If not, that we'll take a look at how much we already have scheduled for the next meeting in December. We don't, it's not a matter of urgency, but in a timely manner, we'll take a look at that.
Certainly.
And then the last thing is that I wanted to ask about our disabled access to the county buildings. I noticed that Burlington has announced that they're going to do a review of the access for the disabled. Of course, when President Bush died, was reminded that the Americans with Disabilities Act was passed during his Republican administration by a bipartisan initiative. I think the Congress at that time was controlled by all the Democrats. So that was quite a remarkable accomplishment for all those people in Washington at that time. I think, if I'm not mistaken, we had a report in September 2016.
Yes, that's correct.
Where our county buildings were audited for compliance with the ADA.
Yes.
So can we get an update on that sometime in the near future?
Certainly can.
Whether or not we need to go into things to the depth that Burlington described what they're going to do. I don't know if we already have a report that was done in 2016, maybe it just needs to be updated.
I would say so, yes. Our inspections director, Robert Key, and head of facilities, Buddy Weitzel, went around in 2016 and checked our buildings and came up with lists of actions that we needed to take, and I know that they've been working on that and have implemented many of those. So we'll get you an updated version of the report, and just I'll email it to the commissioners, and you can look at it and consider it. Will that be okay?
I think that'd be good.
I think you maybe release that to the press as well.
Sure. Maybe we could, if you'd like, we can work it into an agenda item.
Maybe do it as an agenda item so that the public is fully aware of what we're talking about doing, the transparency and accountability to the public for our business. That'd be a good thing.
We will do that.
Thank you. And welcome, Steve Carter.
Thank you.
Glad to have you up here. Look forward to working together.
I do too.
Great. Is there anything else before the board? If not, all our business being concluded will be adjourned.
Thank you for watching the Alamance County Commissioners meeting. Meetings of the Alamance County Board of Commissioners occur on the first and third Monday of every month in the Commissioners' Chambers at the County Office Building at 124 West Elm Street in Grand. Typically, the first meeting of the month occurs at 9 a.m. and the second meeting occurs at 7 p.m. Changes to the meeting schedule will be posted on the county website at www.alamance-nc.com. The video of this meeting is broadcast on LocalGov TV. Please go to www.localgovtvnc.com for more information about this schedule and to see more videos produced by your local governments. You can also access this meeting through our website at www.alamance-nc.com or at our YouTube channel. Technical questions regarding this meeting's broadcast or production may be sent to our county webmaster at webmaster@alamance-nc.com. This address is for technical questions only. Comments and questions about the content of the meeting may be made to the commissioners themselves. You can find their contact information at the Alamance County website at www.alamance-nc.com. There, you can click on the link that says County Commissioners to learn more about our commissioners, read minutes and agendas of commissioner meetings, and find other information about the county commissioners. You can also send mail correspondence to County Commissioners, 124 West Elm Street, Graham, North Carolina, 27253. Again, thank you for tuning in to the Alamance County Commissioners meeting. Thanks for tuning in. If you're watching on YouTube, be sure to hit the subscribe button to stay up to date on all our latest video content. If you're watching on LocalGov TV, be sure to visit their website to see all of the content made for you by your local governments.